Right, we start off with our first big story. An Abuja High Court sitting in Kubwa, Abuja, has nullified the appointment of Ali Modu Sharif as the chairman of the People's Democratic Party. Now, in doing so, the court declared his appointment as null and void in a suit instituted by the party's factional youth leader, Danladi Ayuba.
No counsel appeared for Sharif when the case was mentioned in court. Justice Nwamaka Ogbonna upheld the previous judgment of the same court, which sacked Sharif in June, saying it had not been appealed against. She also directed Sharif to stop parading himself as the PDP's chairman or acting as same.
At a meeting of high-power delegates of the People's Democratic Party was held in Port Harcourt in place of the proposed convention, which failed to hold.
During the makeshift convention, at least that's what they call it, and the party secretariat, the tenure of Mekarafe caretaker committee was extended by 12 months and election into national offices suspended. The 7-man committee has also been expanded into a 13-man team whose members shall not contest for any national position within the party.
Now, the national convention will now take place next year with the hope that the current crisis would have been resolved.
Fight about the machinations to stop this convention. The fact that this convention is holding is a testimony to the resilience, to the creativity, to the doggedness, to the determination, to the incredible resourcefulness of PDP.
Then the tenor of the National Caretaker Committee and authorized the expansion of its membership at the National Convention of the People's Democratic Party on day holding in Port Harcourt on 17th day of August 2016. As for that note, that there are pending litigation ordering on the party or otherwise of the elections of national officers at the 17th August 2016 National Convention with divergent decisions of the High Courts in Nigeria. We have for that vote that it is necessary, therefore, that the matter of the propriety or otherwise of conducting elections into national offices of the party be resolved before the conduct of the said election.
It was up to question. In the support of the motion that should be the suspension of the election of national officers of our great party, say aye. If you oppose to the motion that there should be the suspension of the election of national officers of our great party, say nay. The ayes have it.
All right, we have joining us on the breakfast, Adetokunbo Pierce, Publicity Secretary of the People's Democratic Party, Lagos State. And secondly, as we get along, we have guests joining us from our studio in River State, as well as Abuja. But we'll let you know as we get along. Now, let's start it from the studio, Dr. Pierce. The crisis in the PDP has been on for some time, as the case may be. And with all the moves by committee set up to resolve, committee set up to ensure that everything works out amicably, doesn't seem to be working. What's the issue right now?
I think that the problem is that the leaders who are supposed to resolve the conflict are not acting in really good faith. That's my opinion. Because President Jonathan advised that the McCarthy committee goes back to Modu Sharif to negotiate a settlement. Modu Sharif has laid out some terms, such as the convention, if it's going to hold, should be held in Abuja.
Yes. And not Port Harcourt.
And not Port Harcourt, because and that Governor Wike should not be the chairman of the convention because is prejudiced, this is his own opinion, and therefore Abuja will be a neutral ground, such as that. Then he also suggested something, that the convention committee should not be made up of people who represent McCarthy's interest only. I feel that those terms, those conditions are reasonable for negotiation. Now, extending the convention for another 1 year, it really means, in effect, that the party has no structure to operate as a party. Because who is going to be the spokesperson for the party? Who is going to be the chairman of the party who will conduct affairs of the party? Who is going to be the secretary of the party? This caretaker committee is just an ad hoc group put together to bring the party back together. So for 1 year, we're not going to have a focused and organized political party in the PDP.
Is there no possibility that that time could can be shortened for if they resolve the cases in court and the two factions are now back together? That 1 year, can it not be lifted?
It can be. And I think that it has to be the court. You know, the court has to decide this, because I don't see the two sides actually negotiating a peace settlement. So I think that the courts will eventually decide this for the party.
Yeah, but when it comes to the courts, it is the court that has been part of the reason why maybe confusion sometimes. It is the court, because when we have rulings and there are counter rulings on the issue of Makarfi, there are other rulings on Modu Sharif. Now, the latest one now is from Abuja saying Ali Modu Sharif shouldn't parade himself as chairman. So the confusion continues, it comes from the courts.
But I think that, I'm not a lawyer, but I feel that if one group appeals and it goes on to appeal, whatever decision comes out of that finally goes to the Supreme Court, then the judgment is made. We have a system in place. I don't know why this has not gone all the way.
Were you put banking on the fact that they should go to the Supreme Court? Because according to Justice Abang, he's alluding to the fact that perhaps the Supreme Court will have to weigh in here. Was Ali Modu Sharif faction backing on the fact that would go to the Supreme Court?
You know, I personally feel that it is a disservice to the party and to the nation, who should be expecting a viable opposition, for us to be talking about McAfee faction. And I don't belong to a faction. I am trying, my comments are to find a way to resolve our differences. And I think that it can be done if the Supreme Court, I didn't even know that Justice Abang is going that way too. That's what I think will eventually resolve it. If it goes that way, then before 1 year, something would be decided and we will go with that. That's okay. My opinion.
Let's get to the basics.
Yes.
The People's Democratic Party has a constitution that guides every single conduct and the processes of either election or whatever it is that guides its principles. And we expect that in the vacuum, or in the place of the vacuum of any officer, there are procedures to filling such posts and the procedure to handing over the baton to the next elected officers, as the case may be.
Simple as it may sound, that's exactly what I've said. People are not acting in good faith. All the rhetoric, all the drama, doesn't make any sense. You know, they're acting in impunity. This is the way the governors have been imposing candidates on the party and has created confusion. This is what happened to Jonathan. We also have in our constitution zoning, the zoning formula. Once you deviate from that, you have conflict, you have confusion. You have a problem, you have complexities that you cannot resolve. I think these are the things that are happening. I don't know. People would try to quote that. People would quote the Bible to suit their purposes. They're quoting the Constitution to say that there is room for a caretaker committee. I couldn't find anything like that in the Constitution. I went back, read it, I couldn't find it. Therefore, once you make the error, the mistake of having a structure in place that is not bound by Constitution, that is not backed by your Constitution, you have a problem. And I think that's what we have now with this McAfee
committee. Ordinarily, according to your constitution, the Board of Trustees were meant to have come together and resolve this issue and perhaps handle what the caretaker committee is handling now. Is that correct?
I believe so.
Okay, so if that is the case, why didn't, even before it got to the stage, why didn't Ali Modu Sharif faction listen? Because point over and over again, the BOT, as I remember, tried to make peace, tried to reach out to Ali Modu Sharif, and
probably because
really
the BOT itself is divided.
Okay.
That's the problem. I think that if this thing, if there is a there's a constitutional position to oust a chairman in midstream, I think it would have been done. Mudu Sherif would have been gone. I think that it just does not exist. And that's why you're having this problem now. And what I think President Jonathan suggested was that talk to Mudu Sherif. If you are not going to discuss his terms and you are telling him to withdraw his cases from court, I don't think that's negotiation. I don't think we'll ever have peace because nobody is bulging. And he gave his terms. I think until we go along and discuss those terms, and out of five terms, conditions, maybe two or three will be accepted and so on, maybe then we can begin to talk about progress.
The committee has been extended now. You have about 13 members now instead of seven. Mm-hmm. Is there any likelihood, any, just perhaps any person from Sherif's camp will be part of the,
you know,
committee
that's one
now.
Of the terms that he suggested, that this convention committee should not be made of only people that Sherif has chosen. Maybe if indeed this extended committee includes some of his spokespersons, some of Mudu Sherif's people, maybe that will be a way forward.
Okay, help enlighten us generally what the specifications of the constitution is when it comes to the absence of a chairman. What should be done and how should it be done so that maybe we have an understanding of where the missing link is in here?
Look, I think that these leaders have abused this constitution, misread it. Do you know that McAfee's term of 90 days expired on Monday? And then you have a convention on Wednesday. So technically, his chairmanship of that committee was null and void by Monday. So you have all these lapses going on and creating problems for themselves. I think that what the Constitution says is that the convention will be opened by the chairman, whoever that chairman is. The problem began when we went to Port Harcourt May 21st, and Mudu Sherif
Would you say the convention held yesterday? Would you say that?
No, there was no convention.
There was no convention, okay. So the point you're trying to raise now about the chairman of the committee tenure has expired, that he has no right to have called that convention.
Yeah, because...
But the convention didn't hold.
Yeah, but they called the convention. And that's what created the problem. So, look, it should have been done differently. It should have been done differently. Now, May 21st, when Mudu Sherif technically was still the chairman, unchallenged, right?
Yes.
He was legally supposed to call the convention. Once he has called the convention, then the convention will hold. He did not call the convention, and yet
people got together. But did he call that
on Port
Harcourt? No. The first
that's
convention.
That's what I'm talking about.
He called that, didn't he?
No.
That's what
I'm talking about, no. The fact that you announce a convention, it's not the same thing as when you get to the convention ground, you say, okay, the meeting opens now. Hmm? When he got there, he said he has information that he should not call the convention to order, and he did not. The governor said, some of our leaders said, we have come here for the convention, and whether you call it or not, we are going to have the convention. And because you have not called the convention, we sack you, and we put a caretaker committee in place. That's where the problem started.
All right.
My own viewpoint.
Okay. Now, let me bring in here the former secretary of the People's Democratic Party, River State, Ibibia Walter, in here, joining us from our Port Harcourt studio. Yeah, Mr. Walters, it's good to have you on TVC Breakfast. All right. Now, the point there is we're trying to look more towards the overview of a resolution in the People's Democratic Party in here, looking at what has been happening all the while. Now, there doesn't seem to be a clear-cut direction towards resolution so far. What is going on from your perspective?
The convention was held yesterday. The People's Democratic Party has given a reasonable space for all litigations to be resolved, and the McCarthy caretaker tenure has been extended by a maximum of 12 months. That simply means that in 3 months, if the issues are resolved, we can call up convention. If in 6 months the issues are resolved, we can call up on convention. In 9 months, but maximum is 12 months.
All right, Ibibia, before you joined the conversation, we have a guest in the studio here, Adetokunbo Okumbo Pierce, who said that the convention shouldn't have held at all. And the court, Justice Abang, already said the convention should not hold, it should be suspended. But here you are saying the convention held. So you flouted the court's order to hold the convention?
No, we did not flout any court order. We obeyed the court order in Port Harcourt for the convention.
So there was no convention?
There was convention. We did not flout any court order. We obeyed a court order in Port Harcourt. There were a lot of court orders, some from Abuja and some from Port Harcourt. Abuja says do not hold. Even in the evening of yesterday, there was yet another court order from Abuja that McCarthy is not our chairman at all. And if that we keep obeying the letters, then he has no contention anywhere. We obeyed the Port Harcourt court order to hold our convention.
All right, but what held yesterday, would you call it a convention directly?
What is a convention? You saw the dignitaries there. You saw National Assembly members there, all of them. You saw the state chairman of political parties, almost all of them. You saw the governors and all of them. So what's a convention?
Yeah,
a
there are still several other principal officers of the PDP who were not at the in Port Harcourt yesterday.
If you have a majority, that's why politics is a plural thing. So if you have majority of the party, you say it is not a convention.
All right.
Even when there are no crises, is it every person that attends a convention?
Okay. Can you walk us through this?
Some people may. Yeah, well, definitely. Look, it's very simple. We have seen the masquerader. We have also seen the costumier of the masquerade. We have also seen remove the mask from the masquerade. But President Goodluck Jonathan bequeathed a transition that was peaceful. The world is watching. Nigerians are watching. Democracy in the 17th year is suffering more than it has suffered from year 1 to 16. And then we are entering the 18th year of democracy. It is terrible. It is terrible. I have never seen in my adult life where
Ibibia, I'll come back to you shortly. Now, you said earlier on that there was no convention, in Port Harcourt. Now, I'd like us to understand this.
If he said there was a convention, then they disobeyed the court order from Abuja. Now, I said there was no convention because the convention site was sealed off. They did not go to the convention site. They retreated to the secretariat of the party. Okay? So, what kind of convention? What do you have in a convention? You have election. Mudu Sharif has opposed the election of chairman, national chairman, national secretary, and national auditor. That those three positions. Had election in 2014 and their term ends in 2018, that there should be no election to those positions. There were no elections to any position yesterday. So how could you say you have a convention? That's why I said there's no convention. I don't mind if they had a convention, they didn't have a convention, it doesn't matter to me. What I'm saying is, look at what happened, and what happened was they did not go to the convention site because it was sealed off by the police. They went to the secretariat, one. Two, you have, when you have a convention, you have an election. They had a congress, they had a meeting, but they did not have a convention because there were no elections.
Okay, Abibia, now let's talk through this. And if you follow your constitution, does it say anything about the chairman of the party declaring the convention open? Abibia, can you answer
that? The you are aware of the situation. On the 21st of May in Port Harcourt, the chairman absconded, Ali Mudu Sharif absconded, and the deputy national chairman, Uche Secondus, declared the convention open.
Okay.
So in the absence, our constitution allows the deputy chairman to act in the absence of the chairman. This convention of the 17th is a continuation of the convention of the 21st. If people have gone to undercut the party, if people have gone to court to cause problem for the party, maybe people think, maybe somebody like the man speaking on your television from the Lagos angle, the publicity secretary, he said he is publicity secretary of the PDP, and a publicity secretary that is not with the PDP in times of trouble, I do not know if he is actually a publicity secretary.
All right,
the convention venue was barricaded by government, by police. There were no problems in Port Harcourt. The convention has to shift to the party secretariat where decisions are taken. He said when once there is no elections, then it is no convention.
All right, we've established that fact. We've established that fact
even without election.
Okay.
All right, you're watching TVC Breakfast, and we are discussing the crisis in the People's Democratic Party from all the developing stories happening around. And then certainly we have the publicity secretary of the People's Democratic Party, Lagos State, in President Dr. Adetokunbo Pierce in the studio. And in Port Harcourt, we have the former secretary of the People's Democratic Party, River State, in the person of Abibia Walter. We are discussing this. Now, Abibia, let me come to you still on this before I allow Dr. Pierce answer or respond to this. Now, Dr. Pierce earlier said that if the convention ground that was agreed upon was sealed off by the police because of a court order and there was a movement to somewhere else, and if it holds, if the people come together, it's still a violation of the court order. What's your reaction to that particular instance of the issue of the fact that there's a violation of a court order there?
Our man at the TV station, the publicity secretary of Lagos chapter of our party, is completely aware that there are conflicting court orders of coordinate jurisdiction. We're not saying that the PDP disobeyed appeal order or the police obeyed an appeal order. The police, the military, the government choose to obey the Abuja court order, and the PDP choose to obey the Port Harcourt court order. And so we did not violate court order.
All right, back to the point we're trying
point
to make.
Clear.
All right, the convention was called. The chairman of the caretaker committee declared the convention open. But from what we have, the tenure of the caretaker committee expired on Monday.
The 21st of May convention was declared open by the deputy national chairman, Prince Yusuke Secondus. And then the party decided to institute a caretaker committee. And the yesterday convention was declared open by the caretaker committee. He stood in for national chairman. Caretaker committee is national chairman. McAfee has been our national chairman for about 3 months. The convention decided, convention is gathering of party members. Convention decided that the McAfee tenure be extended by 12 months maximum. And the membership of the caretaker committee be increased to not less than 13. It is a convention decision. Convention is where you go to take decision. Election in party offices ideally happens once in 4 months. So, but the party allows for convention yearly. And you see what is happening. A party members or former national chairman so appointed, decided to give so much trouble to the party. And then if someone somewhere is saying and what he is doing is good and the party should fold her arms, the majority, sinking majority, a mammoth majority should fold her arms and just queue behind such a man that has gone so wild, such a man that we have on marks, that is doing some sinister activities, such a man that is doing like he's a drunken man in a China bar. We should not allow that to sink our party. A lot of people are interested in sinking our party to avoid credible opposition. This is not what PDP bequeated to Nigerians.
All right, PDP Walters, that's the much time can permit us for now. Certainly, we thank you for talking to us on TVC Breakfast. All right, you're still watching TVC Breakfast. Now, let me come to you, Dr. Pierce. The issue of extending the tenure of McAfee by 12 months, how does this compound the issues on ground?
Let me say first and foremost to my colleague that I am a friend of the party to the core. I am interested in settling the differences. I am not supporting conflict. I feel I am very sorry, and it's very disturbing that we have this conflict now. But I think that the only way we can solve conflicts is by being truthful and by understanding that we cannot force things the way we want. You have to be diplomatic, you have to be very careful. And they are not being careful by trying to force things on Modu Sharif. All I'm saying is it won't work that way. That's why we're having this conflict extended till now. We need to take a different approach. I think impunity in the party is what the problem is. That's why we had problems in 2015 election. Listen to what he said. The deputy chairman has the right to call a convention. Not true. Deputy chairman's role is what the chairman allows him to do. The chairman did not say, Secundus, go and open the convention on my behalf. That's one. So you can see there's a problem there. So chairman is watching and saying, so you people think you can just sideline me? What does the constitution does not allow
for
this?
Chairman to have taken the whole bunch of people who converged there for granted and walk away?
No. What happened there, I said before, that as far as the chairman was concerned, he said, look, I got a court order this morning that I should not go on with this convention. And I am not going to go on with this convention. That's why he decided not to hold the convention. Now, they decided that they're going to, you know, sidetrack that side of the court order.
What was the court order?
Pardon?
What was the court order he got?
That he should not carry on with the convention. Just like they got the court order yesterday that they should not. So he decided. I don't blame them for accepting the court order from Port Harcourt that it should have a convention. But listen to this now. They did not have a convention. Are you telling me
that they went to Port Harcourt yesterday just to go and extend the term of the caretaker committee. No, they went there to have elections to the offices that were vacant. They wanted to have election. They did not have the election. Therefore, there was no convention.
All right.
How could they have gone there just to extend the term of McCarthy? That could have been done by the BOT or whatever body in Abuja. They didn't have to go to a convention to do that.
Okay. Dr. Adetokunbo Pierce, Publicity Secretary, PDP Lagos State, thank you for talking to us this morning.
Thanks for having me.
All right.